Very good morning, kids. Welcome to St. Georgia Girls School, Hajipur. Hello, welcome back, class 9 kids. Today, still we will continue with the chapter, Is Matter Round Us Pure? Topics for the day will be separation techniques. Physical separation is possible of all the components of heterogeneous mixture. It is based on differences between certain physical properties such as solubility, boiling point, freezing point, magnetic properties and sublimable nature of the components. Kids, we have studied about separating components in class 6 as well, but simple methods such as hand picking, sieving, filtration. Class 9 will focus on evaporation, centrifugation, separating funnel, sublimation, chromatography, distillation and fractional distillation, ultimately magnetic separation. What is evaporation? All of you are very well aware with this word. It means that the volatile component or the solvent is separated from the non-volatile component or the solute by heating the mixture at a specific temperature. It works on the principle of heating. You can see in the diagram, there is a mixture kept and heat is provided. Thus, you can use this method for separation of diaphragm ink and separation of salt or sugar from its solution in water. The second separation technique is centrifugation. It is an important method for separating from a liquid component or a solvent an insoluble component, which is the solute, and that solute is disposed haywire in the liquid component. A centrifuge machine is used for this purpose. Basically, the centrifugal force causes the disposed solute to settle down as a sediment part, and that is known as the pellet. The liquid part or the solvent is left behind. You can see in the diagrams lower below. Before, all the solute particles were disposed, but after them being placed in the machine, which works on the rapidly rotating rotor principle, that means when you place the mixture in this machine, it rotates rapidly, very similar to the washing machines that we have at our homes, and thus the solute part gets settled as the sediment and the supernatant is left behind. There are various uses of centrifugation. It is used to dry clothes in the dryer or the washing machine, then cream from milk, separation of the various components of blood, as well as separation of cell organelles from the cell. The next technique is use of separating funnel. In this scenario, it is used to separate two components which are in liquid state but are insoluble and differ very significantly with respect to their density. Normally, when you allow the mixture to settle down for some time, you'll see that the low density liquid separate out and a different layer is formed above the high density component. It is used basically for separation of kerosene oil or water and vegetable oil or water. See, this is how it is done. The mixture is poured and it is allowed to leave undisturbed for some time. You'll see that higher density liquid settles at the bottom, the low density liquid remains on the top, which is later on separated out. Sublimation is the very next technique we will study. It is basically used to separate components of the mixture in a scenario when one is a solid and the other component is sublimable. That means it will directly change its states from the solid state to gaseous state. It is very simple. When you heat the mixture, the sublimable component will separate out as vapors. These vapors are condensed to obtain pure component. It is used to separate mixture of solids in which one component of that mixture is sublimable. For example, separation of ammonium chloride from sodium chloride.